What is stalking, and why do public service leaders need to know about it? Stalking is unwanted, repeated behaviour that causes the person who experiences it fear, alarm, or distress. Victims might not label what's happening to them as stalking, especially early on. They might describe it as something else, like being hassled, pestered, or harassed. Stalking takes many forms, including sending texts, emails, gifts or letters, making malicious or repeated phone calls, following, and even impersonating someone. It can involve other crimes too, like burglary, criminal damage, and threats to kill. In some cases, stalking escalates to assault, rape, and murder. Stalking commonly occurs after relationships have ended, especially those in which there has been domestic abuse. Stalking indicates a high risk of serious harm. By identifying stalking as soon as possible, you stand the best chance of protecting all those involved. We sometimes wrongly associate the term stalking with celebrities, but anyone can be stalked and anyone can be a stalker. There are many reasons why someone might become obsessed or fixated by another person. Consider the following stalking scenarios. An ex-partner who can't accept a relationship is over. An individual who persists in wanting a relationship with someone who isn't interested. An aggrieved employee, client, or patient who is resentful or angry about a genuine or perceived injustice. Some, but not all, stalkers suffer from mental illness. Some are highly dangerous, not only to their victims, but to friends and family, colleagues of the victim, and the wider general public. The experience of stalking is not rare. It's estimated 5 million people in Britain experience stalking each year. 1 in 5 women and 1 in 10 men will experience stalking in their adult life. So why do you need to know about stalking? Because this issue affects the staff you have responsibility for and the clients your organisation works with. Let's think first about your staff. From an HR perspective, stalking is harmful. It has a detrimental effect on the victim's day-to-day life, health, relationships, emotional well-being, and their ability to do their job. Certain public sector workers face a higher risk of being stalked, including healthcare professionals or high-profile individuals such as counsellors or other public figures. The workplace provides key opportunities for stalkers to target their victims. Organisation technology, phone lines and computers can be used for this purpose. Whilst they are the exception, there have been a number of high-profile homicides where victims have been stalked and killed at work. In relation to your client group, where a client is being stalked, either by a partner, ex-partner or acquaintance, or stranger, this must be taken very seriously. It is a very risky behaviour. A significant number of homicides have featured stalking prior to the killing. Stalking may indicate that others close to the victim are potentially at risk. So as leaders, what can you do? Publicise this issue. Many people don't know what constitutes stalking and that something can be done about it. Ensure any complaints of harassment or stalking behaviour, i.e. pestering, hassling, bothering, are recorded, recognised, named and taken seriously. Signpost those affected by stalking to specialist services and the police. Raise awareness of how your service will respond to stalking. Keep statistics on stalking. Monitor its incidents and outcomes within your service. Make sure your violence against women, domestic abuse and sexual violence workplace policies address stalking. As commissioners, ensure that specialist violence against women, domestic abuse and sexual violence services keep stats on the incidents of stalking presented to them and are equipped to provide a service to victims who are stalked by their ex-partners, including completion of a stalking risk assessment.